Our choice of analytics primarily depends upon the type of variables we are analyzing. If we have categorical variables, usually what we would perform are cross-tabulations, because averages and standard deviations mean not much for categorical variables. So again, reinforcing some basic points that cross-tabulations make sense for categorical variables, and there are other tabulations, including proportions, that we can demonstrate and use for this purpose. Some empirics make sense for continuous variables, such as age. You can compute mean and modes and standard deviations. But when you're working with gender or tenure, these are categorical variables. So proportions or percent of male versus percent of female and similar tabulations make sense. And often we obtain these results through cross tabulations. SPSS has a powerful cross tabulation module, and the user interface looks like this. Essentially, we select variables that show up as rows, others as columns. Usually it's one variable as rows and another with its categories in columns. We make selections for how the data are presented and what statistics we would like to demonstrate, and click OK for results. So let's look at the cross-tabulation between gender and tenure. You have the variable female instructor, those who are female, yes, and males as no, tenured professors as yes, and untenured as no. And this is how you see the results. But essentially, you can't make much meaningful results from it, because it says that female instructors who are not tenured are 50, and male instructors who are not tenured are 52. It appears that more male are untenured than females, but then a percentage would be more meaningful here. That is the proportion of males versus proportion of females who are tenured. So you will see that 26% of females are untenured compared to 19% of the males, even though more males in terms of raw numbers, 52 versus 50, are untenured. So how do we do this in SPSS? We click on Analyze and Descriptive Statistics, Crosstabs, and we select female as rows and tenure in columns. And for cells, we say show the percentages in rows. So the percentages would add up to 100% for rows. Continue and say OK. And here's the output. You could see that 25% of the females versus 19% of the males are untenured. So from a percentage point of view, a higher proportion of females are untenured compared to males. We will not discuss this in great detail, but you can test the statistical significance of these relationships using a chi-square test, and it's easier to call this test. We're not going to explain here. We will discuss this under hypothesis testing, but I'll demonstrate how you can compute this. So I will recall the dialog box, and under statistics, I'll select chi-square and continue, and if I click again, I get the same output plus the chi-square test. Again, how the interpretation and detail how to read this, we'll discuss later.